Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss the another two type, which is of the form integral 1 upon ax square plus bx plus c, or you may come across the another form which is 1 upon square root of ax square plus bx plus c. Now if you just notice, in the denominator in both of this form we have quadratic equation, okay. The one we have without the square root and the another one which we have with the square root of the quadratic equation. And how to evaluate this integral? So the first step is make the coefficient of x square as 1, 1 means unity. Find the third term is the formula we have given you, that is half the coefficient of x square, or sorry, the whole square. Then the third term is add and subtract the third term. And the fourth one is apply suitable integral form, or we can say the formula, okay. This is the special integral formula, okay. Total we have 7 special integral formula, but here we are going to need only 6. The first 3 will be for the 1 upon quadratic equation when you come across, and the another 3 form, that is 4th, 5th and 6th one, will be using for 1 upon square root of the quadratic form, okay. Now the proof of each of this formula has been given in my last videos, you can check in the playlist, okay. Well, just so we'll solve this question which is based on the same form, okay. Now the first one here is says I is equal to integral 1 upon 5 minus 4x minus 3x square dx. Now if you just notice, we have the coefficient of x square as minus 3. So first of all, what we need to do, we have to get rid of this minus. So we'll take this minus as common and we'll take it on the numerator. So that becomes 3x square plus 4x minus 5. Okay, or you can think it as multiplying numerator and denominator with the minus 1, okay. Now the first step, making the coefficient of x square as 1, so we'll take 1 by 3 as common, that gives you minus 1 upon x square plus 4 upon 3 x minus 5 upon 3, okay, dx. So for the first step is done. Now we'll find the third term, okay. Now this third term, we have the formula as half into coefficient of x. So the coefficient of x here is 4 upon 3 the whole square. Now this gives you 4 by 6 the whole square. If you just cancel it with the table of 2, that gives you 2 by 3 the whole square, which is 4 upon 9. Now we have got the third term. After getting the third term, what you have to do, you have to add and subtract in the denominator, okay. So I'll write it here, I is equal to minus 1 upon 3, I'll take the minus outside, that gives you 1 upon x square plus 4 upon 3x. Now since we have got the third term, first we will add this term, then close the bracket, then you will subtract the same term, okay. And then you will write your constant. Now in my case, my constant is minus 5 upon 3, so I'll just write it minus 5 upon 3 dx, okay. After this, minus 1 by 3. Now if you just look out for the first 3 term, this is nothing but the square, the complete square formula I have got, but how to write it? So first you have to take the square root of x square. The square root of x square is nothing but x, okay. Then you have to take the sign of the x. So the sign of x is plus, so we have to take plus over here, okay. Then take the square root of this third term, that is 4 upon 9, so we have to take the square root, that will give you 2 upon 3 and make it as a square. Now if you just open this square, you will see that you get this 3 terms, okay. You can just check it out. Now this 2 terms we have to solve it. So if you see, in the denominator we have 9 and here we have 3, so we can multiply 3 in the numerator as well as in the denominator, so we get the common denominator as 9, and in the numerator we get minus 4 minus 5 into 3. So minus 4 minus 15 gives you minus 19, as I have already written minus here. Okay, now next thing what we can do here, we can take the minus and give it to the denominator again. Okay, so that will just reverse this thing. That will give you 19 upon 9 first, and then it will be x plus 2 by 3 the whole square, okay, dx. Now after this, again we have to convert it into suitable formula form. So we have to write it in the square form. We have this in the square form, but we have to write this in the square form. So what we can do, we can write 19 as root of 19, and 9 can be written as 3 the whole square minus x plus 2 by 3 the whole square. Okay, now if you just check it here, we have these two terms. Okay, this is your constant term, okay, and this is your x, right? So if you just check it out in the special integral formula, and also we have the minus in between. So the first thing is the constant. Constant means in the formula we have a as a constant, okay? So we have the second formula, or we can check this third formula is matching. We have 1 upon a square minus x square, the constant square minus x square, that is 1 upon 2a log of a plus x upon a minus x, okay? So here we will apply the same formula. Okay, so I'll just rub this out because that is not needed right now. Okay, so that will be 1 upon 3 multiplied by 1 upon 2a. So a here is root of 19 upon 3, okay, log of a plus x. So root of 19 upon 3 plus x plus 2 by 3, you can have the bracket, then root of 19 by 3, that is a minus x, so minus, and we will draw the bracket because we have the minus outside, and you have to take the mod of this whole thing. Okay, now this 3 and this 3 will get cancelled, we left with 2 root 19, correct? Then log, multiplying this numerator as well as with the denominator by 3, because we have the denominator as 3, so that will give you root of 19. First that 3 will get cancelled and x will be multiplied with 3x plus, again this 2 will get cancelled, so we left with 2 plus this root of 19, minus will taken out inside, so that will give you minus 3x, and that will again give you minus 2. You can take the minus inside and multiply numerator as well as denominator with 3 as a common LCM, okay, plus c. So this is how you can find your first sum that I have solved it by using the same steps that I have given you, but you also need to learn the formula. Okay, now we'll move on to the next one, that is I is equal to square root of 1 upon square root of x minus 3 and x plus 2. So here we have the two factors. We don't have the quadratic term, but we have the two factors. So that's not an issue. We can just, you know, multiply this whole thing and we will get this. So that will give you x square minus x minus 6 dx. Okay, so we have got this quadratic form. Now we'll perform the same steps. First, you have to make the coefficient of x square as 1. So here we have already as 1. So no need to make it, no need of the first step. Now we'll come across the second one, which is the finding of third term. So third term will be equal to half into coefficient of x. X coefficient is minus 1 here, the whole square. So that gives you minus 1 by 2 the whole square, which is 1 by 4. Okay. Now I is equal to 1 upon square root of, so this will give you x square minus x, we have got third term as 1 by 4, so we'll add this first, close the bracket, then we will subtract it, and then we will write the constant that we have, that is minus 6 dx. Okay, then again 1 upon square root of, then we have to write it in the square form here. So take the square root of the first term, which will be x, take the sine of x, which is minus, and take the square root of the third term, which is 1 by 4, that is 1 by 2, the whole square. And here you have to do the LCM. Here we have the 4 and here we have 1. So multiply this 4 and 4. Okay, so that gives you minus 1 minus 6 into 4. That gives you minus 25 upon 4 dx. Okay. Again, we have to write the same two terms in the form of a square. Okay. So that will be 1 upon square root of x minus 1 by 2, the whole square. Now 25 can be written as 5, and 4 can be written as 2, the whole square. Now if you just see, we have the square root, and in the square root, first term is your x term minus second term is your constant term. So if you just check it out in this special integral formula, so we have here, that is fifth one, 1 upon square root of x square minus a square, that is nothing but log x plus, the same square root is repeated, mod is closed, then plus c. Okay, so we are going to use this same formula. So let's just, okay, so here we have x as x minus half and a as 5 upon 2. So we'll apply the formula log of x. So x will be x minus half, okay, plus x square minus a square, the same term you have to just copy here, you don't have to expand it, close the mod, plus c. Okay, after this what you can do, the first term will be as it is, that is x minus half, okay, plus, and here you don't have to expand this again, because even if you expand this, overall you will get this term, that is 1 upon square root of x square minus x minus 6, because from there only we have founded third term, then we have make it as a square term. So overall, if you solve this whole term under the square root, you will get this x square minus x minus 6. So you just have to just copy this, plus 6 minus 6, close the mod, plus c. Okay, so this is how you can find it. Okay, just make sure you just don't solve it. Even if you solved it, you will get this same only, but that will just waste your time. Okay, so you can just copy from your the question. Okay, now we have this, the simple question here, that is integration 1 upon 25 minus 9 x square. Okay, so here we will perform the same thing again. You have to do the coefficient of x square as 1, so we will take 9 as common, so that will give you 25 upon 9 minus x square and 1 upon 9 outside. I have taken 9 as common, then we can write this both of this in the form of a square. So that will be 5 upon 3 the whole square minus x square. Okay, now 5 upon 3 whole square, that is the constant part, and this we have the x square. Now here no need of finding the third term and all, because we don't have the term of x here. Okay, so now we'll apply the formula. Okay, you can check in the formula list, which gives you 1 upon 2a log of a plus x, that is 5 by 3 plus x upon 5 by 3 minus x, close the mod. You can do the LCM in the next step. Okay, so this 3 will get cancelled 3 times, so 1 upon 30, you will get 3 into 2 into 5 log, multiplying numerator and denominator with 3, that gives you 5 plus 3x and 5 minus 3x, close the mod, and plus c. So this is how you can calculate it. Okay, the simple one it is. Okay, so this is how we have solved the three simple question based on this form. Okay, along with the steps I have given you, you can copy the steps, you can learn these formulas and you can solve this kind of questions. Okay, now this kind of question is very famous and it may come for your board exam. Okay, all the best.